Hello everyone, how are you? I hope you all are fine. So last time we were discussed about that the ionic bond. So ionic bond is formed between the metal and non-metal. For the metal, we know that in the ionic bond, metal loss of electron. Because metals are electropositive in nature. So we can also say that the oxidation will take place on metals. Because in the electronic concept, loss of electrons means oxidation. And in the case of non-metals, gain of electron. So gain of electron is called as a reduction. So we can see that in the ionic bond, that is when ionic bond will form, then on metal oxidation will take place and on non-metal reduction will take place. It means in an ionic bond, oxidation as well as reduction take place. So it is called as redox reaction. Because a reaction in which oxidation as well as reduction take place, it is called as a redox reaction. How? Let's discuss with the NaCl. NaCl is an example of that is an ionic compound. How it will be formed? First of all, Na lose one electron and convert into Na positive. And next, Cl gain one electron, convert into Cl negative. It means here, loss of electron, it is called as an oxidation. And here, gain of electron, it is called as reduction. And the process in which oxidation as well as reduction take place, it is called as redox reaction. So it is a ionic compound, that the behavior of ionic compound and the, in the ionic compound also redox reaction will happen, like oxidation as well as reduction. So let's discuss about that is a covalent compound. Next topic is covalent compound. In the last video we already discussed about the covalent compound also, but it's not in the detail. Covalent compound or covalent bond. So how covalent bond will be formed? Covalent bond will also form in the two atoms. That atoms are non-metal and non-metal. It is the one difference between the ionic and the covalent bond, because in the ionic bond will be formed in between the metal and the non-metal, and here the covalent bond will be formed between the non-metal and the non-metal. So let's example H2 hydrogen. Suppose it's a one first hydrogen and this one is a second hydrogen. As we know that the atomic number of hydrogen is a 1, so according to that atomic number, atomic number is equal to number of protons, and number of protons is equal to number of electrons. So it means hydrogen contain only one electron. Because the atomic number of hydrogen is 1, it means that the electron is 1. So this is the first hydrogen contain only one electron, and this one is the second hydrogen that contains one electron. It means the mutual sharing of electron take place. Mutual sharing of electron. It is the second difference between the ionic and the covalent bond. In the ionic bond, a completed transfer of electron will take place, and in the covalent bond, a mutual sharing of electron will take place. And this attraction, and after the attraction, hydrogen bond will form, because hydrogen also want to complete its duplet. What is the meaning of duplet? Two electron in its outermost shell. So hydrogen want to complete its duplet. With the sharing of electron, hydrogen easily complete its duplet, like this one. Understood? This hydrogen also completed its duplet, and this one also. Normally in the metals and the non-metals, like in the elements, every element want to complete its octet. इट इज कॉल्ड एज अ ऑक्टेट रूल. ऑक्टेट मींस 8 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन इट्स आउटर मोस्ट शेल एंड इट इज अ रीजन व्हाई मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स लूज इलेक्ट्रॉन एंड व्हाई दे गेन इलेक्ट्रॉन्स बिकॉज ऑफ कंप्लीट इट्स ऑक्टेट. ऑक्टेट मींस 8 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन इट्स आउटर मोस्ट शेल. सो वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द कोवलेंट बॉन्ड. सो कोवलेंट बॉन्ड will be formed between the non-metals and the non-metals. Here it is the first example between the covalent bond, and next one is nitrogen. Suppose in case of the nitrogen has 7 electron in its outermost shell. Okay, so nitrogen, the atomic number of nitrogen is 7. It means it contains 5 electron in its outermost shell, not 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here the nitrogen that is attracted by the another electrons that contain the nitrogen, it is a only share pair of electrons, not a completely transfer of electrons. It is a main difference that the what is the meaning of covalent bond and what is the meaning of ionic bond. Ionic bond is a complete transfer of electron, and then the ions will be formed that are positive and negative. Positive is a cation and negative is a anion. But here we talk about the covalent bond. It is mean normally that is the attraction, that is the mutual sharing of electron. So with this, nitrogen contain triple bond. First one, second one, third one. It is a nitrogen compound. Okay. So next example is oxygen. In case of oxygen, first oxygen, second oxygen, and we know that the atomic number of oxygen is 8, so it means its electronic configuration is 2-6. This oxygen contains 6 electron in its outermost shell, and this oxygen also, due to the octet rule, every atom, every element want to become stable to complete its octet. It means 8 electron, but this oxygen have only 6 electrons. So mutual sharing take place between the two electrons of the every oxygen, and then O2 will be formed. That is a O2. Okay, so it is also a covalent bond, but here covalent bond first one in the hydrogen, that is a single. In case of oxygen, double. In case of nitrogen, triple. Understood? These are the covalent bonds. So some properties are also there as same as the ionic bonds. What are the properties of the covalent bond? So some are the the heading is properties of covalent bond. First is the weak forces of attraction, because in this only sharing pair of electron take place, not a complete transfer of electron. So it means here only weak forces of attraction will take place. Second one is here only mutual sharing of electron. Third one is melting and boiling point. As we know that in the covalent compounds will be formed with the help of the weak forces of attraction. It means we required a less amount of temperature to remove the forces of attraction, to break the forces of attraction. It means the melting and the boiling point will be lower. Understood? Why lower? Because of the weak forces of attraction between the particles. Okay, so here the nature is also polar as well as the non-polar. How non-polar? We already discussed about the N2, O2, H2. These are the compounds when the non-polar bond will be formed. Non-polar means because polarity of any bond, like non-polar and polar, these are depends on the electronegativity. And what is the meaning of electronegativity? एलिमेंट हैज अ टेंडेंसी टू अट्रैक्ट इलेक्ट्रॉन टुवर्ड इटसेल्फ इज कॉल्ड एज अ इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी एंड इट्स अ ऑर्डर ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी लाइक फ्लोरीन ऑक्सीजन नाइट्रोजन क्लोरीन ब्रोमीन आयोडीन सल्फर कार्बन हाइड्रोजन. फ्लोरीन इज अ मोर इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव कंपाउंड इन द पीरियोडिक टेबल होल पीरियोडिक टेबल. इन पीरियोडिक टेबल अप्रोक्सीमेट 118 एलिमेंट्स आर देयर बट फ्लोरीन इज अ वेरी मोर फ्लोरीन इज अ मोर इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव एलिमेंट इन द पीरियोडिक टेबल एंड दिस इज अ ऑर्डर ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी. लेस इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी हाइड्रोजन अप्रोक्सीमेट सेम दैट द कार्बन एंड द हाइड्रोजन द इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी अप्रोक्सीमेट सेम. So if we talk about that the covalent compounds for in the organic chemistry then that the complete not a complete transfer of electron only mutual sharing of electron will take place then in the organic chemistry the bonds will be formed between the carbon and hydrogen. Okay, so we talk about that is the polar compounds and the non polar compounds. These are the non polar compounds. Why these are called as a non polar compounds? Because in here two nitrogen atoms, it means one nitrogen and one nitrogen. Electronegativity will be same in oxygen, electronegativity same, hydrogen electronegativity same. But if we talk about the HCl, that is hydrochloric acid, electronegativity will be same in HCl or not? Let's discuss about the polar compounds, polar covalent compounds. So in the polar covalent compounds like HCl, in case of HCl, hydrogen has a different electronegativity and the chlorine has a different electronegativity. It means it is a difference between the electronegativity of both the atoms. So this bond will be formed with the help of two electrons. First one electron of this, second electron of this. But due to the more electronegativity of chlorine, this bond will be shifted toward chlorine atom like this. Suppose here the bond will be like this and here some bond shifted towards this and partial, that is delta positive charge will be on hydrogen and delta negative charge will be on chlorine. Delta means that a partially delta like this is, and it means is partially not completely, small amount of delta will be, delta positive will be there and delta negative will be there due to the difference between the electronegativity of the atom. So next one is solubility. Normally the non-polar compounds are insoluble in water. Non-polar compounds like H2, N2, O2, these are the non-polar compounds. So insoluble in water. But if we talk about the polar compounds, like polar compounds, covalent polar compounds, polar covalent compounds. So these are soluble in water because of the nature, because of the polar nature. Understood? So next is, I am going to discuss about the coordination bond. How the coordination bond will be formed between the elements or between the compounds. Suppose coordination bond. Coordination bond will be formed between the elements or the compounds. Suppose water. We know that the structure of water, that the oxygen is a central atom that contain the 6 electron in its outermost shell. And here two hydrogens, this one hydrogen and this one hydrogen. So hydrogen contain only one electron. It means shear pair of electron will take place and oxygen complete its octet and hydrogen complete its duplet. In same in the this case, the hydrogen completed its duplet. So after the formation of the water, two lone pair of electrons are there. Lone pair of electron means that are not participate in the formation of bonds, that are called lone pairs. So normally if we talk about that the acids, suppose acids have the property, normally the acids have property like we talk about HCl, HNO3, H2SO4. These are the acids and these are the properties when dissolved in water to give H positive. Suppose this acid will give H positive, and here we want to combine this H positive with this oxygen. So it means this H positive has no any electron. Then how bond will be formed? Here oxygen give lone pair of electron to hydrogen and share the electrons between hydrogen and the oxygen, and these type of compounds, these types of bonds are called as a coordination bond. Which type? H2O. Here oxygen has the two lone pair of electron, and we want to add it H positive with H2O. It means this lone pair will be attracted by this, and this next H3O positive, that is hydronium ion. In the hydronium ion, coordination bond will take place. Hydronium ion. Understood? I hope that you enjoyed the lecture in the covalent bond and the coordination bond. So next time we'll meet again with the new concept, with the new videos. Thank you all of you.